My name is Tim Wilbur, and I am the Managing Editor of Canadian Lawyer Magazine. I'm proud to present to you 2018's most influential lawyers and judges. In the August issue of Canadian Lawyer, we publish our annual Top 25 Most Influential list. This year, we have five categories: corporate commercial, including litigation; human rights advocacy and criminal; changemakers, which includes leaders, innovators, or catalysts; government, nonprofits, associations, which includes academics and judges; and young influencers, who are lawyers 40 years old or younger. To create our list, Canadian Lawyer sought out nominations from the legal community. We then developed a long list of 177 lawyers and built a survey, where readers were asked to vote for those who they thought made the most significant impact. More than 10,000 voters cast their ballot. With that input, we narrowed down our list to the top 25 most influential lawyers in Canada. I will now turn it over to Aidan McNabb, Associate Editor of Canadian Lawyer, to present the final list of winners.
My name is Aidan McNabb, and I am proud to present to you 2018's most influential lawyers and judges. The winners of the Changemakers category are Thomas Cromwell, former Supreme Court Justice, now Senior Counsel at Borden Ladner Gervais, for his work for the Action Group on Access to Justice and his advocacy of access to justice in general. John Burroughs, Professor and Canada Research Chair in Indigenous Law at the University of Victoria, recognized for helping create the first ever dual Indigenous Law degree program and promotion of Indigenous rights in the legal realm. Sukesh Kamra, National Director of Knowledge Management at Norton Rose Fulbright, recognized for building advanced forms of technology-based applications which are leading to an organizational cultural shift in law. Hadia Rodrigue, lawyer, writer, PhD student, and podcast host, chosen for her outspokenness about diversity in the profession, including her Globe and Mail article, Black on Bay Street. Paul Schabas, partner at Blake, Castles & Graydon LLP, for his leadership of the Law Society of Ontario, where he improved equality and diversity in the profession and reconciliation with Indigenous peoples, access to justice, and the lawyer licensing process. For the Government, Nonprofits, Associations category, Yasir Naqvi, former Attorney General of Ontario, for his work modernizing the justice system in the province. Rachel Notley, Premier of Alberta, chosen for her handling of the Fort McMurray fire, the opioid epidemic, raising the minimum wage, and her public sparring with BC Premier John Horgan over pipelines. Emily Tamman, professor at the University of Ottawa Faculty of Law, recognized for advocacy for refugees, publicly accessible libraries, representation by women, progressive drug policies, and governmental transparency. Richard Wagner, Chief Justice of the Supreme Court of Canada, recognized for his important decisions regarding denial of bail without just cause, discrimination based on mental and physical disability, and outspokenness about improving the Supreme Court's transparency. Alice Woolley, professor for the University of Calgary Faculty of Law, for her work as Calgary's first ethics advisor, where she is aiming to create a tougher code of conduct for mayor and council members and an expanded whistleblower program, and for her work at the University of Calgary making changes to the curriculum to focus on the practical elements of legal education. For the human rights advocacy and criminal category, Supreme Court Justice Rosalie Abella, for her decisions regarding Trinity Western University, unlawful confinement and court delays, and her impact internationally, exemplified by her election to the American Philosophical Society, putting her in the company of people like Albert Einstein, Charles Darwin, and Benjamin Franklin. Essie Kojo, Vice Chairwoman of the Human Rights Tribunal of Ontario, for adjudication of many human rights matters and extensive involvement in the legal community, promoting racialized and black lawyers, mentoring women, and work for the Canadian Association of Black Lawyers. Brian Greenspan, partner at Greenspan Humphrey Weinstein, who is recognized for his involvement in some of the country's most complex and controversial cases, including leading the independent investigation into the murders of Honey and Barry Sherman. Joseph Groya, principal at Groya and Company PC, whose Supreme Court win over the Law Society of Ontario highlighted the balance between civility and the zealous advocacy of a client. Naomi Metallic, professor at Dalhousie University's Schulich School of Law, for her work using the legal practice as a tool for reconciliation between Canada and Indigenous people. In the corporate commercial category, Frank Walwin, partner at Weirfolds LLP, for his advocacy on behalf of racialized lawyers, his creation of the $25,000 Frank Walwin Award in Caribbean Studies at the University of Toronto, and involvement with the Judicial Appointments Advisory Committee at the Ontario Court of Justice. William Braithwaite, chairman of Steichman Elliott LLP, for his representation of Potash Corp in the Agrium deal wherein the two companies merged to form Nutrien. Tom Isaac, partner at Castles Brock & Blackwell, for being a leading authority in Indigenous law in Canada, regularly advising governments across the country. Jeff Hall, partner at McCarthy Tatro LLP, for prominent cases including Ontario Limited versus Toronto Dominion Bank, which had an impact on the banking industry for the scope of a bank's duties to third parties. David Weatherspoon, partner at Dentons, for his work for the Pivot Legal Society, where he was part of a team that saved residents of Anita Place, a homeless camp in Maple Ridge, BC, from eviction. For our young influencer category, Usman Sheikh, partner at Gowling WLG, for his leadership of the firm's blockchain and smart contract group. Rachel Barsky, associate at Narwhal Litigation, who is recognized for her work to vacate the conviction of Philip Taglio, incarcerated for over 30 years for second-degree murder, and her pro bono work for inmates and volunteer work for Innocence Canada. Guillaume Lavoie, partner at Lavery DeBilly, chosen for his leadership of the firm's private equity, venture capital, and mergers and acquisitions teams. Akosua Matthews, associate at Falconers LLP, for her work addressing social justice issues for Indigenous people, including acting for Anishinaabe, Aski Nation before the Canadian Human Rights Tribunal. Lena Yousefi, founder of Y-Law Group, chosen for her success in a precedent-setting child abduction case and her commitment to pro bono legal work. For Canadian Lawyer, I'm Aidan McNabb.